Hi everyone, this is Nidhi and you're watching this video on the Urban Diaries YouTube channel. Since we all know that Christmas is round the corner, we all are doing some kind of preparation for that. Then why not to learn some interesting phrases so that you get a good vocab on this Christmas Eve. In today's lesson, we'll talk about these 10 idioms inspired by the Christmas holiday and its tradition. Without any further ado, let's get started. Christmas came early. You can use this phrase when something good is happening to you, especially when it is unexpected. That means you were not expecting it happen this soon. As in, you applied for a new job and you are expecting the results after a month, but you got the interview call within a week. So you can say Christmas came early. You may also hear a similar expression such as Santa came early this year. My sister just got an appraisal. Sounds like Christmas came early for her. Christmas comes but once a year. What do we do in Christmas? We eat a lot, we spend a lot, and we enjoy a lot, right? And sometimes you go beyond the limits. So use this expression as an excuse to indulge yourself by overeating and overspending. Suppose you baked a cake and that turned out delicious and mouth-watering. Now you keep on eating and eating. So you may say, am I eating too much? But that's okay. After all, Christmas comes but once a year. Again, you're getting married and you go for a shopping in a mall. You can say, I'm gonna buy every single dress I like today. After all, Christmas comes but once a year. Skating on the ice. When we think of this Christmas festival, all that comes to our mind is Santa Claus, jingle bells, and ice skating. And we all know that ice skating itself is a very difficult and dangerous sport. I mean, you might hurt yourself if you don't know how to skate. So use this idiom in a situation when you're engaged in some activity or behavior that is very risky and dangerous for you. And that may also cause a lot of trouble to you. I hope you realize that you'll be skating on the thin ice if you don't give up smoking soon. I always keep myself updated so I don't end up skating on the thin ice when the boss asks me for any information. Stocking stuffer or stocking filler. So we can't always buy very expensive gifts and that's why we need stocking stuffer. We all know Christmas stockings and if we need to fill them with some toffees and chocolates as a surprise present for kids, as it would be very impractical to fill a Christmas stocking with expensive gifts, so cheaper items are purchased to bulk it out. So these toffees and chocolates will be called stocking stuffer. A small or inexpensive gift that is typically placed in a Christmas stocking. This evening, I'm going to buy some stocking stuffers for Christmas Eve. Saved by the bell. When you're saved or spared from a difficult situation by some intervention at the very last moment, you use this idiom. I was saved by the bell. Suppose you are in a classroom and the teacher is about to take a surprise test and suddenly the classroom bell rings. Hooray, you are saved. So how would you express your feeling? You would say, today I was saved by the bell, otherwise I would have got 0 in my test. Next situation. Your dad was about to scold you for not performing well in your studies and suddenly one of your relatives arrived at home and everyone's mood is changed. Now how would you express this? You would say, today I was sure to be scolded by dad but was saved by the bell. So it's just like a signal bell that ends a round in a boxing match, saving a boxer from being counted out. You may call it a last minute reprieve or rescue of something or someone. Be there with bells on. When you present anywhere with your bells on, that means you are so happy and so excited and so glad to join that gathering. So it's kind of an enthusiastic response to an invitation that you get, saying that you'll gladly attend that party. So next time if somebody invites you to the party, you would say, I'll be there with my bells on. A piece of cake. When something is a piece of cake, that means that task is very easy and quick to accomplish. Like making morning tea is a piece of cake. Do you think learning idiom and phrasal verbs is a piece of cake? There is another idiom that can be used in place of piece of cake to indicate a task which is easy or which is not easy. If you know the answer, write that down in the comment section below. Be my guest. This phrase is used typically as a polite response to a request for something. That means if somebody asks you for something, like to use your mobile phone or somebody wanna wear your dress, you can use this phrase, be my guest. With this idiom, you are allowing them to do so. You are letting them know that they can use your dress. Can I try your watch, please? Be my guest. The more, the merrier. This phrase is so clear in its meaning. The greater the number of people, the more enjoyable an event or a situation will be. In a Christmas party, we need so many people to join it so that we can enjoy the party to the fullest. So, the more, the merrier. Good things come in small packages. It's a very well saying. You should never judge something based upon its size. It may be small in size, but it can be of superior quality and a higher value. Whenever you see any child doing a fantastic job, you can say good things come in small packages. Alright guys, these were the 10 idioms that you can use to sound more interesting on this Christmas Eve. Which idiom did you like in this video? Don't forget to tell me that in the comment section. Merry Christmas!